this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a real 3D phone mockup completely in After Effects. Real reflections and all, and without any plugins, of course. Hey everyone, my name is Manuel, and let's dive right in. First of all, let's create the phone. We create a new comp, Command Mac, Control PC, and an 1920 by 1080 pixels. In 3D renderer, we switch to advanced 3D. It comes with restrictions, but allows us to create real 3D objects and environments with lights and shadows. In options, you can adjust the render quality. Be warned, higher quality increases the render times a lot, but looks better, of course. All right, let's add the first shape. We choose the rounded rectangle tool, double click on it. Let's name it Case. Then go into the Rectangle Path 1 group or the property window and set the size to 450 by 800 pixels. The roundness to around 35 pixels. We use a solid fill color, black. Then we turn it into a 3D layer. You get two new groups here. Geometry options, you can bevel the edges and extrude the shape. Let's do that. 30. As soon as you use 3D layers, you have new tools available here to easily rotate, move, and scale the scene. If you activate Draft 3D down here, you also get a grid. And it gets you a low quality preview that doesn't take as long to render. That's very useful when working on a scene. Next, let's create the metal frame. We duplicate the shape layer, name it metal frame, and slightly increase its size. Let's add 4 pixels in height and width, 454 by 804 pixels. Let's change the color into a slightly purple gray. Something like this. You can see this weird color mix here. That's because both shapes are in the exact same position. If we move the metal case 1 pixel back, which is +1 along the z-axis, it looks great. Next, let's add the screen. Did you know there are a lot more resources on my website? Check out my courses, develop motion design strategies for brands, learn how to create smooth animations, or how to animate with expressions in After Effects. Sign up to my newsletter, get your free expression sheet, your free motion design strategy sheet, or download more than 150 After Effects project files. The link is in the description. To create the screen, we duplicate the case shape and shrink the shape size to 430 by 780 pixels. We need to adjust the roundness to around 20. And let's set the extrusion depth to 0. We change the color to white. Again, we need to move it. This time, 1 pixel towards us, set -1. To be able to easily add content to the screen, we pre-compose it. Right-click on it, pre-compose, let's name it pre-screen. We have to turn it into a 3D layer again. The rotation is off, so let's fix that. We go into the pre-comp and make it a 2D layer. We go back into the main comp, looks better. We have to move it 1 pixel again, set -1. Awesome. You can now add your content. Let's quickly add a solid, then add a gradient ramp, adjust the start and end, choose two colors. Because it's a 2D layer, you can use all effects. And we use the screen shape as alpha track mat for our content. And here's the content on the phone screen. You can add more details, of course, like buttons, which are extruded shapes just like the ones we did before. Or the black part along the top for the front camera. The front camera one is a path I drew to get that specific form. Now let's take care of the lighting. The first one we add is an environment light. Under layer, new, light, we choose environment light. If you wanted to cast shadows, click the checkbox. Nothing really changed yet. Next, let's add a spotlight. Layer, new, light again. This time we choose spotlight. Let's position it to the left of the phone so that the light cone looks at the left edge of the phone. You can see it brightens the frame. Let's decrease the cone angle to around 25 degrees. Let's change the comp background into something darker. Command or Control K. And let's choose a dark blue background. Let's deselect Draft 3D to get a better preview. You can see it takes longer to render, but it gives you a better idea of the result. So how do we get reflections on this metal frame? We need to add a realistic environment, with an HDR file. I created the studio environment with Adobe Firefly. The problem? It's a JPEG. And I need an HDR file. We import the JPEG to After Effects and add it to a new comp. Then go to Composition and Save Frame As. And go into the Output module. Instead of Photoshop, we choose Radiant Sequence. The result is an HDR file. We import it, add it to the comp. Then we go into the Environment Light settings and choose the HDR file as source. Then we go into the material options of the metal frame shape, because that's what we want the reflections to be on. Increase specular intensity to 100% and specular shininess to around 85%. And you get reflections. You can adjust the intensity and the shadow darkness in the light options. In Transform, you can rotate the HDR file to adjust the reflections. We don't want the screen to be affected by the light. In After Effects Beta, there is the option to disable Accept Light. Not in the regular After Effects 24.6 version yet. My workaround is to increase the intensity of the environment light and then to darken the shape color. But I think the option to exclude layers from being affected by lights should come soon. One more thing, if you want to animate the mockup, link all the phone layers together. I prefer to add a null object, make it 3D of course, and link all the phone layers to it. On the left side, I've added a video you might like. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye everyone.